Hello and welcome back to another episode of dFIXX, the Decorator's channel.
And on this episode, we're going to look at how we created these invisible switch and socket outlets using the Perception CFX range from Hamilton. You got on the decorator's bench for us, Gary?
Well, I've got a nice cup of coffee. It looks like you've just finished your cup of tea and all the biscuits are gone, so I'm blaming you for that.
Yeah, well, we're dabbling in decorating today, which is a bit of a departure for eFIXX here, but we've got a range of wallpaper, Gary.
Yeah, but we didn't go for anything simple, did we? Look at the patterns and designs of the paper that we selected. We didn't go for anything plain, did we?
No, we didn't. And we've got these socket outlets and switches to have a look at where you can seamlessly blend them into the wallpaper, and I was, to be quite frank, a little bit scared when these turned up because, yeah, you're right, there's some high-end wallpaper here, and having to cut it to fit these exactly, yeah, we were a bit...
And you're going to see our first attempt as we get through this presentation, so hold on for that, but I think, first of all, let's delve in and have a look at the actual switches and sockets themselves.
Yeah.
So we'll bring this in. Where do you want to start? You can start with the switch?
Yeah, so the first thing, the screwless accessories.
Okay, yeah.
So, which obviously normally means there's a front plate on. To get that front plate off, it's screwdriver in. That pops off.
Okay, so that's a clear plastic front. Okay, and there's a template, but that is not just a template, is it?
Yeah, so it's a template to cut wallpaper, but you can, if you want to match a specific paint finish, you can just paint this. So this is like a lining paper.
We didn't do that though, did we? That would have been easy, wouldn't
it? That would have been easy, and it wouldn't have really demonstrated the full power of this range, really, and I think it is fantastic. So apart from that, it's the usual quality you'd expect from Hamilton in terms of their accessories and a vast range of finishes in terms of the rockers and the switch mechanisms and the actual inset as well.
Yeah, so yeah, the full range is there. And we think it almost future-proofs the accessories within your installation, don't we?
Yeah, well, you know, we're in Yorkshire here, Gary. We're a little bit careful sometimes with the money. Yeah, so if you invest in this range, you're set for life. It doesn't matter what you do with that wallpaper or that paint colour. You can just clip the front off and, yeah, cut a new insert in there and, yeah, you're away.
So we've gone from rope edge maybe to chrome, to brush chrome, to black, to nickel and everything in between. But with this range, it's only the wallpaper that changes and our accessories blend in, therefore we stay on trend.
I tell you what, you could probably print off a picture of a rope edge brass and put that in there.
That would be novel, wouldn't it?
You could go back to the future then.
Yeah, we could. Yeah. We're obviously not going to. And yeah, it's going to take a little bit of a technique, isn't it? We were very patient when we did ours, and you're going to see that as we go through, in order to get it cut in perfectly. But the results are splendid, aren't they?
They are. I mean, I love this. We've had a lot of fun. Yeah, in doing this, yeah, we've had some tense moments, but yeah, I think it's a fantastic job. I mean, I love this cycling paper here. Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, so shall we see how I got on for my first attempt when I did, I think it was the socket outlet just here, and obviously the four gang switch here.
Let's have a look at Origami Gary. So let's prepare the wall for the wallpaper. First, we're going to use these new splates to help us out, Gary.
Yeah, they're usually used when marking walls for plasterboard over the front, but we think by having that solid edge all the way around, it will make it easier to remove the wallpaper that will sit in there that we're going to need for our template.
Yeah, so just get some paste on. So I'm deliberately not pasting over the splates itself because we're going to recover the wallpaper around the socket box.
So we're going to just roll it down, yeah, making sure we go onto that splate. Now this is really good because of those four corners, we can actually pop that through the paper, and because the splate's in place and there's no empty box, I'll have a hard edge to run round with my knife.
Yeah, so just lightly press those through so we can find the edge of our box behind there.
Okay, so I'll bring that edge up so I now know that splate is in place. I'm not going to fall into an empty box and potentially rip the paper that I'm trying to salvage in the center or the paper that was going to be left behind around the outlet.
Yeah, okay, and it's, it makes life a lot easier. You've got something to put that straight edge against, and we are using a sharp scalpel here.
Yeah, I'm sure there's other techniques. Again, I was just doing this on the fly to see how I could come up with the easiest possible one for me. So this section here, just going to take this out.
Yeah, so we're not going to use this for the final socket, we're just using this as a template to get the exact mark of the repeat on the pattern. So you can see the splate behind it there. So now we can remove that as we fit this socket.
So we're going to need to retrieve the template and obviously fit it, a screwless socket outlet. So as we lever them out, as we always do, we can take the clear front and the template out of the way. That template's really important. And we said before, if you were painting the wall, say you were going for Magnolia, you could paint the inner a magnolia colour and still have...
If you were going back to 1970, Gary, yeah, you could do magnolia, it would be something, elephant's breath or something these days, okay. Something to be on trend.
I'm sure you'll mention chip paper at some point.
Yeah, you can't use wood chip with this, I think you'd struggle.
Okay, so now we're going to prepare both accessories. So,
we've got some dolly switches there, and they've just got these little bezels that you remove with that tool.
Yeah, so pop those out of the way, and then obviously I'm going to retrieve my template again, fit it to the box, and then I'm off and running. Just pop it out. Take a screwdriver. Exactly the same as we've shown before, just clip it out of the way.
Yeah, same to sort of the usual metal framed screwless accessories we've seen on the channel before.
Okay, so pop that one out. And retrieve my template. So just gently get that one out of the way and then fit it. And then I'll show you how I went about my first one for the socket outlet. This is my first attempt, so I'm learning as I go. I'm going to use this actually as the template rather than cutting out from that.
Okay, so this is the exact piece of wallpaper we need to match the pattern that we've got on the wall, but we need it slightly bigger to fit that clear plastic plate.
So first of all, I'm going to be a little bit bigger than I need to be. By using the clear plastic plate and going round it, I'll be larger than I need it, but that will make it easier when I do the next stage. Yeah. So just bear with me.
So you've reversed that plate, so it's the flat front surface that's lying down against the paper there.
Yeah, just made it a little bit easier. So it's a hard edge to run around with my pen. So take that all the way round, and now I've got a nice fresh piece of wallpaper to work with. So move this out of the way. You'll be able to see what I mean by that. So drop that out. And now you can see the template. I'm going to keep the gap at the very top and all the way around it the same. So that will be that running edge all the way around it is at the same gap. Therefore, when I drop on my knife, I'd love to just take a very small slither of that template with me. So if you watch here, that means I'm absolutely on the running edge of that template.
Yeah, I can see that, yeah.
So I'm going to go all the way around again. We said if this was an inexpensive wallpaper, you're probably going to struggle. This is a very thick, expensive wallpaper. Obviously, that blade is cutting into it beautifully.
Yeah, that's it. And we've got a cutting mat behind here. So, yeah, it's best to have a good surface to cut onto as well, and a sharp blade.
Because it's symmetrical, I can use it on the back. Just be careful on the single sockets that you get it in the right way round. So I'm going to mark it out now using a pen, okay, pencil or a pen. We had a pen at hand, so I'm just going to mark around it with a pen. And then I'm going to cut that out as well.
Just like being back at school, Garrett?
Well, when I did go, yeah.
Maybe doing brass rubber next?
Yeah, I'm sure I will. So you can see now, there we go. I've got to now cut that out. And again, I improved my technique here. I was a bit cautious, pressing really firmly. So you notice my hand is shaking slightly. So the amount of pressure I'm putting on it, I don't want to go around two or three times. Yeah. I've done the straight lines first, but I think my second technique is better. Yeah. So,
any decorators watching this, chip in with your advice here. So we're just dabbling decorators here.
Yeah, I'd really appreciate that feedback as well. So as I come round, I'm more interested in getting it absolutely right than the speed involved.
Yeah. So, well, charging by the hour.
Yeah, pop this one out. So, yep, this one comes out. So just gently tease it out. And okay, we don't need that bit, yeah. So still don't know whether it's in the right place, but there's the first one. Now what's the second technique? I roll it, I leave the blade on.
All right, your speed knob.
Yeah, it got me more confidence. So run down the edges and then just rotate the paper. There you go, and then I'm around the corners. Yeah, that did make a big difference as well.
Yeah, and again, sharp blade and a good cutting surface makes a big difference as well.
Yeah, I wouldn't be confident to use a pair of scissors.
No, or that rusty Stanley knife you use normally.
Yeah, that's right. There we go. So now we've got to see whether it's right. So it's out a fresh piece of paper, not the piece that was behind the splate. There we go. Lay it into position.
Yeah. So this is a time to make sure your hands are clean. You don't want fingerprints on the wallpaper or on the plate itself.
And then just click into position. It's quite satisfying. This is it clips in. Just make sure it clips all around the actual outlet itself. Just push it firmly into place and you step back. And I think I've made a reasonable job of that.
That is a perfect match.
Thank you.
So let's have a look at that switch. That should be easier because they're just round holes.
Yeah, just exactly the same process. I used the template. I used the extra piece of paper on top of the wallpaper, exactly as I've just shown for the socket. Yeah. I could have been a little bit more liberal here with these holes because of the dolly that would have covered them.
Yeah, the bezel on the dolly. Yeah, that fits up. Yeah, you have got some tolerance there. But
I went for a snug fit.
Yeah.
And popped that one on. considering that's my first two efforts at doing this. It may be slow, but it's good.
Yeah.
Let's finish these off.
Okay, so just going to put the bezels back on, then just the tool just to nip them up so you don't over tighten them because you distort the plate. But it looks pretty good. Obviously, you've got them in line. Wouldn't want them out of line, but yeah, it's a great match.
We're no decorators, and I'm sure we just proved that. Wow, when you take your time and you go through the stages and you've got the kit, I suggest that sharp knife and this board here was really crucial to it. Let's have a look at what we had.
Let's have a look at your remnants, so we can see the bits you cut out there, Gary. Yeah, this is our cutting board. We found that useful, the sharp scalpel and the splates, which is something we haven't used before. It's not really meant for this purpose, but I think, getting that straight edge so we could identify a bit of wallpaper around made a big difference.
Yeah, and look what you get when you're left over. You know, it's that top end. You know, people are going to come into your installation, they're going to look at that feature wall. You're a big fan of wallpaper, aren't you? And you think you're going this way, don't you now?
Well, Mrs. R, yes. I've had a few heated discussions when it comes to fitting wallpaper. Yeah, especially when you mess it up around those difficult edges. Now, that's the thing. You obviously put a lot of attention into cutting out them. The electrician, we'd suggest, needs to put the same level of care into making sure that the back box is level. I don't think you'd get away with having a box that isn't level and then having to adjust it on the adjustable tabs in the back box, because you really do want that bang on with the wallpaper.
Yeah, so a little bit of care from us. And we're not suggesting the electrician necessarily is going to be the one doing the wallpaper, but if you're doing it at home, you might be, mind you. And in your case, that might be
it. And I say for clients, this is, I think, is a great option. It's something unique. Yeah, again, the clear bit stops you obviously damaging around the socket. I like it. And there's even attention to detail as well. So we've got, we haven't stepped you up to doing the USB version yet, Gary.
We weren't going to mention that.
There's a little bit more
involved in that one.
Yeah, and obviously we always we love a regulation on eFIXX, and part of those regulations you have to identify the charge current.
And they've got a little sticker for that, haven't they?
Yeah, so there's even a little sticker that comes on that you could stick underneath the wallpaper to identify the current as well. So it's that attention to detail we're used to seeing from Hamilton. I love this range. You know, what do you think of the Hamilton Perception CFX range? What do you think of our dabbling in decorating? I'm sure you could throw some top tips at us. If you've fitted this range before, put some comments in below and help others. And just feedback, always welcome. And we'll see you on the next edition of
Decorate Your Fix.